Yeah, that's it. I hit the wall there, I don't know how, but apparently has a much larger hitbox, or, and the rocket's rather unstable, so. And what kind of class are you? You would be a sharpshooter, so you're trying to sharpshoot people. Don't worry, I got your back, bro. There's one thing I'm good at, it's being a kill-stealing whore. So, the Berserker is actually touted as one of the more powerful classes. Because you apparently get a damage resistance with it as well. And there's two people on me. Yeah, that can get kind of bad when they're getting up on you. And this is the problem with this class is it's not exactly well known for being it's not exactly the kind of class you can teamwork too well with. I mean, you sort of can, but you have to be very careful. So I'm gonna use my radar here. There we go, I got one of you suckers. Good enough for me. And I think I had that sharpshooter helping me, so thank you very much, good sir. You can be my best friend now. I have that Vulcan. I want to try that gun. So that's probably going to be... Well, I think the one the next class I'm going to do is actually going to be... Okay, we got him. Apparently that was missing a lot. So maybe I'm gonna switch back to it. Fuck, and I haven't still looked at what the weapons are doing, so. I don't know, I'll try and die really fast, okay, on purpose this time. Radar is definitely an interesting side grade to for an ability for this class. Okay, well, there's a turret behind me shooting me somewhere. And that's it for me. So, let's just take a quick look at what these do. So this is a slow-firing weapon that deals... So it's terribly ineffective, and this one is... it's basically the same. Like, the distance is like... the accuracy is like 40. This one's like slightly better, but less damage, but fires faster. So I guess, you know, I guess I would want the mini flak instead, but I think this game's about to come to an end. So there is a slight variation. Just kind of feels a little weird that I have to be holding down the button. I usually don't like weapons like that. I usually much prefer to kind of get in there, do my damage, and get back out. Looks like I'm the final kill here. That was rather unfortunate, I couldn't really make it anywhere. And 15 seconds, let's see if we can get one more. I'm pretty sure we lost and I did not help at all. I died the most in this team. Yeah. Well, that's a shame. Especially in a game like TDM, you know, I don't like being the guy who dies the most because it's just you're contributing to the other team's kills, and I don't know how close that was. Not that close, but you know, if I hadn't died 8 times, I guess that would have helped somewhat. Play more cautiously. And another 95. So this is what I mean. Like, I play 15 minutes, I get 100 points, and so your placement matters only about like 6 points, which is pathetic, to be honest. Like, I get 6 points for that, for what, being in... I don't know what placement this is. I guess it's like technically 3rd in the game. No, 4th in the game. So it's 6. So that doesn't really boost you up much, and I think I got even more when I, the first time, you know. So just, I don't know. I still think it's rather slow. Look, I'm up to 614, and I'm not even fucking close to getting an internal in my mech, like an actual like a small minor upgrade in my mech. But you know, I've complained about this already many times, so we don't need to hear it some more. So, what fancy schmancy map are we playing on now? Does this scramble teams every time we join? Because I don't know if it does. It should. It should scramble them based upon player abilities, but I don't know. We'll see. All right. Get our scout out with the mini flak we're going to play with this time. And it's this map. So, not a huge selection of maps, but, you know, there's a couple of game modes that we can still play. You know, I've only done these because I think these are the most that I would excel in. You're gonna have to help me, bro. Oh, wow, there's two of them shooting at me. I could get pretty bad. Level 20 Berserker. So, you know, as I said, in most of those situations, I don't feel like I'm doing less damage or that I would have done any differently. Like, cause it's like, I think I would have died anyways. So we dropped our radar here. Hey, these guys are hanging out. Okay, I do not want to be a part of that. Come on. Take him out. Oh, are you kidding me? Oh, fuck's sake, overheating. This is not the time or the place. And I died to another guy. He literally had like one bar of health, and I'm like, ah, I could get away with that. See, heat, I think, is the biggest problem. You're in an engagement, you know, you barely have enough to take out guys it is when you're getting at least like a lot of your hits. But it's like that those last couple which they make a difference. And they can kind of piss you off. I like that range. I like that new range. Uh-oh. Alright. Let's just touch up on my repairs. Fortunately, I saw some power. Fucking hell. Really? There's nowhere is safe on this map. Nobody has. I'm the only person on this team who has kills. That's awful. And I've kind of spawned behind these guys. So let's go engage some of these guys. I don't think I finished that guy off. Unfortunately, his friend is now going to finish me off. Nope, that's it for that. Level 18 Rocketeer. And you know what, I think this is the best example actually of the game not balancing teams at all. Like, look at this, we have a level 18 Sharpshooter who's killed absolutely nobody. I don't know how he got to level 18. But we also have, they have two level, high level guys, so this is not really that balanced at all. What the hell is it with this? Why, I see arrows on the ground. Alright, let's go drop a radar. Fortunately, they're all out in the open, so I do not have much of a choice, but I can flank. Overheating. Got him. I think I just walked past one of their enemies. I'm not too sure about that, though. He has no idea I'm here. And that worked out really well in my favor. Holy shit. It's just, you know, sometimes it just can be absolutely amazing how well you can do. Oh, you took my kill. Well, you know, it's about time the team started getting kills, even if it is taking mine. I've worked really hard for these kills. Go get him. There we go. Good job, buddy. Took my kill again, but that's okay. Wow. See that jetpack? You can stay in the air for a long time with that. And it's just that ability is what makes that happen. And it can make the difference between life and death sometimes, depending upon how hard their weapon is to hit when you're in the air. Yeah, some guns are harder than others. Alright, it's unfortunate I cannot get up here, and I don't know really what to do. Don't run from him. Stop, don't be a pussy. Unfortunately, I think I'm gonna die if I go over here. There we go. Oh, get low fuel. We're in good shape anyways. Let's just repair for a second. Also, I would have wanted to put down one of my little radar things. I mean, it's practically one of the best things I have. But as I said, I'm only using the defaults. This is pretty much how you'd be playing it if you just unlocked it and you didn't get any of the internals, because I don't have enough money to buy all those. Aha! You are dead. And I got an assist for that. It's actually sort of pathetic how badly this team is doing. I feel ashamed. I'm gonna commit some sort of mech warrior suicide. I'm gonna just overheat my core constantly and get down there. I kind of just like moving cars around. All right, let's put a radar here. There we go. No, nobody there. Are they actually like? I have a feeling they're working as a team. They're like, let's just go hide. Or not. Oh, took my kill again. Well, whatever. Kind of upset now. Oh, no, no, no. Come on. Bring me up here. There we go. I wonder what kind of interesting place we can go to here. I want to try being a sneaky, sneaky guy. Alright. Let's go right here. Nope. Apparently I cannot. Oh, well, can I? Hey, look. It's Pikachu. It's Pokemon. What the fuck? Alright. Well, let's go flank these guys. That's one kill. Kill. And number three. Just starting to overheat. Let's go cause some hell for this guy. Got assist for that one. Alright, we need to go and heal. Buckle down, sucker thumb. Hello, repair bot. Clipping through the wall. My good friend. Clipping through the. I'm gonna call him Clippy. Alright. And apparently, I cannot put my radar down again. It's unfortunate. I don't know if they can actually see it and take it out. Oh, 33 health. Okay, I need to repair really badly. And my team has my back, except for that guy I'm a little bit concerned about. Oh, I'm so dead. I'm surprised that I didn't die. Okay, and then just as I say that, he gets me with a seeker, whatever the fuck that is. Okay, so you know what? Actually, my final opinion is I think that the mini flak is definitely better than the normal flak. Unless you're going right up to them and doing that burst damage, it's good for two situations, essentially. God damn it. Ah! The hell did he get me with? Apparently he can chase me pretty far. Pretty much as far as a lot of other mechs can go. It was a terrible spawn for me. I kind of contributed to one of their kills there. It's completely not intentionally though. Come on, don't do this on me now. Oh, did you see that? That was a good rocket. You know, when these TDW rockets hit sometimes, it's actually quite nice. It's a good feeling. It's a nice weapon, I just wish it wasn't being used 4 frickin' times. Yeah. You I need a chainsaw. It's an add-on. I don't know why in that last little bit he just wouldn't die. Oh, I got another one just before I died. That was good. I consider that a death worthy of my scout mech. So despite this mech's obvious limitations for range and all that kind of stuff, I enjoy it. And I think it's gonna be one of the ones I play on a regular basis. Like, just as a kind of gotta go fast mech. Just, you gotta close that distance. It's not something that works particularly well in anything but this game mode, to be honest. Well, you know, it's fast, so it actually would work pretty well in a lot of game modes. I don't even know what the fuck I'm talking about anymore. You know, I'm just formulating thoughts in my head and I'm thinking to myself that it should be good at certain things, but it's not. But yeah, as I said, very clear limitations. It's not like a lot of the other mechs, which are just kind of like, oh, you're kind of good at a lot of things. Wow, I killed a guy. Let's get in there. Poor guy. I think that's one of their mechs. Hopefully he will not shoot at me. He's probably too distracted with my teammates, and I would be correct, so I am very lucky. And enemy sight, like as I said, that radar really helps out. It's like it practically tells you where they are. And I don't know how easy it is for them to see it, but the fact I've never noticed one probably explains it all. Got him too. We're on a roll now. We can maybe win this. Come on, guys. Come on, Mike. Don't get fucking hit by like a billion rockets. And nope, you killed yourself. So maybe you robbed him with the kill. We're up one, so we can do this. Don't switch to another class. Here. We got this. It's only a minute 40 left, so let's just do some sneaky kills. Hopefully they don't work together. Fortunately, I think I kind of caused a problem for my friend there. I prevented him from going away. For some reason, I was unable to... Okay, there we go. I kind of want to prevent them from killing me. I forget. I had to... Oh, shit. Let's go down here. I'm having difficulty finding a good place to hide. Because I look at my radar, it's like, oh god, a billion guys out of nowhere. We are tied. Come on, guys, stick together. Stick together, team. Don't be a dumb Mike. It's amazing. This is pretty. No, don't fucking run in there, buddy. You're getting flanked. Die. All right. Just go down here, repair, because you know, worst case scenario, I spend the last couple minutes running around. Oh, fuck. You know what? We win. That's it. It's over. Because they require too many kills to win that. Holy shit! We won, guys. That was pretty cool. Even though that guy got higher on the scoreboard, I like this guy, Railgun. A man after my own heart. That's ridiculous. Me and him were... I almost did better than him. I don't really know why I didn't, because I guess he just did more damage. And once again, 106 pathetic points for doing this. And I got my level up, and so now my one of my alts got a little bit better. And that's it for this. So I hope you enjoyed, and that goes to show the power of Scout if you play it in a proper way, which I was not doing for the longest time. So I hope you enjoyed the Scout class, and next time we'll probably get into... I think we're done with all the light chassis, so we're going to probably dip into some heavies. So I'll see you later. Bye.